This is Dr. Hatem Eleishi from Dr. Hatem Eleishi Medical Center in Cairo, Egypt. Now, we start the first video of our series, What are autoimmune rheumatic diseases? Autoimmune rheumatic diseases are several different diseases that affect the joints of the body, as we see in the figure. That's why, if you have an autoimmune rheumatic disease, you have to see the rheumatologist. The rheumatologist is the physician who is concerned with problems of the joints and of the musculoskeletal system in general. Examples of common types of autoimmune rheumatic diseases are rheumatoid arthritis, ankylosing spondylitis, psoriatic arthritis, vasculitis like Behcet's disease, systemic lupus erythematosus, Sjogren syndrome, Still's disease, reactive arthritis, and many, many more types of rheumatic diseases. In addition to affecting the joints, some of those disorders can also affect other selected body organs sometimes. Which other organs are affected depends on the specific autoimmune rheumatic disease we are talking about. They can affect the eye, causing inflammation called uveitis, lacrimal gland causing dryness of the eyes, salivary gland causing dryness of the mouth, lungs causing shortness of breath, intestine causing colitis, bloody diarrhea, different types of skin rashes, kidneys causing impairment of the kidney function, maybe your blood pressure goes up, blood vessels causing lessening of the blood flow to the organs to which the blood vessels were going, nerves causing neuritis or neuropathy and numbness. And that's why the rheumatologist might sometimes need to communicate with doctors from other specialties for optimal management of those patients who have autoimmune rheumatic diseases. Some patients might think, if I have an autoimmune disease, then my immune system can wake up the next morning to randomly affect any other organ in my body and attack it. That's not true at all. Even if you have an autoimmune disease, your immune system still is not crazy and will not hit any other organ by mere chance. Every autoimmune rheumatic disease has a specific list of other organs in the body that it might affect, just a mite, it's not a rule, and it will not affect the others. It will not affect the others means we are again confirming it is not a random thing. For example, the autoimmune disease called rheumatoid arthritis, it affects the joints. Might also affect the lungs, salivary glands, or lacrimal glands, or some other organs. It will not affect the pancreas or the spleen. Ankylosing spondylitis, another autoimmune rheumatic disease, affects the joints of the spine. Might also affect the eye or colon. It will not affect the brain or the small intestines. Psoriatic arthritis, another autoimmune rheumatic disease, affects the joints, affects the skin, might also affect the eye, will not affect the lymph nodes. Behcet's disease affects the joints, blood vessels, will not affect the thyroid gland, and so on. Autoimmune rheumatic diseases can affect patients of all ages, from infancy to childhood to adulthood to old age. They are not restricted at all to a particular age group. Certain diseases are common in certain age groups, though. Ankylosing spondylitis more commonly starts in teenage years and early adulthood. Polymyalgia rheumatica almost invariably starts after the age of 50. Autoimmune rheumatic diseases affect males and females. They are not at all restricted to a particular sex. Certain diseases are more common in a particular sex, though. Systemic lupus is much more common in females. Reactive arthritis is much more common in males. Most autoimmune rheumatic diseases are chronic or semi-chronic. Rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, lupus, and many more disorders are chronic disorders. Reactive arthritis is supposedly a chronic disorder also, but many patients achieve a satisfactory resolution of symptoms and remission even within 12 months of treatment. Few of the autoimmune rheumatic diseases are transient or intermittent, episodic though. Palindromic rheumatism is an intermittent disorder, on and off attacks of arthritis. Some forms of self-limiting autoimmune arthritis can start and remit within a few weeks, never to come back. So the conclusion here is that autoimmune rheumatic diseases are several different diseases that can affect the joints of the body. In addition, they might also affect other selected body organs sometimes. The specific set of organs affected, if any, depends on which autoimmune rheumatic disease we are talking about. Autoimmune rheumatic diseases are mostly chronic, with exceptions. affect all age groups and both sexes with some special age group and sex predilections. Patients with those diseases should be seen and followed up by the rheumatologist. Now that was the end of the first video of the series. The next video will be why this autoimmune disease happened specially to you.